Life City family, what is up? It is Bobby. I'm still deep undercover here at the Costco in the suburbs, filming lots of videos. Hey, I gotta take advantage of being undercover when no one recognizes me so I don't get kicked out. And I'm approaching the bread aisle right now. I wanna show you the best breads to buy here at Costco, why they're the best breads, and why you should avoid a lot of them, in my opinion. We also gonna talk about nut butters and jams here because they go together like a perfect combination. Before we get rocking and rolling, like, subscribe, share. That's the only way this channel keeps growing the way it has. There's also a bell icon right below the video. Enable all notifications. That way you get a push on my channel as soon as I go live. These masks are driving me crazy, but let's talk about bread. All right, here it is, the great wall of bread at Costco. And spoiler alert, the best bread here is actually not in this section, it's in the freezer section. So hang on a minute for that. But let's just go over a basic bread. Someone might see this, Sara Lee honey wheat bread, and be like, oh, wheat's really good for you, I'm gonna get it. Bread is very deceiving, my friends. It's all in the details. I'm gonna explain to you what some of these ingredients mean. So here's the Sara Lee bread. When you see enriched wheat flour, run, Forrest, run! That is not the kind of bread you want to be eating, because when it's enriched, they took a whole grain, whole wheat, they stripped all the good stuff away. What's the good stuff? The bran, the germ, the fiber. They stripped it down to the simple carbohydrate. And then the funny thing is they stripped it down because it makes it easier for the refinement process. But then they say, oh, we're gonna put it back in there, B1, B2, folic acid. So they take out the good stuff and then put in synthetic nasties. After that, we have the synthetic vitamins. Then we get down here, soybean oil. Anytime you see a bread made with soybean oil, put that back. First of all, you don't even need oil in there. Second of all, soybean oil is one of the most highly processed, highly refined oils on the market. It's GMO, it's high in omega-6s, low in omega-3s, which is bad, and it's inflammatory, and they use a chemical called hexane to extract the oil, soybean, and canola from the plant. So that's bad news. And then it gets even more troubling if you think it couldn't possibly. Look further down here. See this word right here? Datem, D-A-T-E-M. That, my friends, is a chemical leavener. It makes the bread bake quicker. Why would you want to bake bread quicker? Because it's money. The quicker you can get this out of the factory onto the store shelves, it's money. That's a chemical leavener that makes the bread process much, much quicker to bake. You don't want that, okay? So you might be like, well, Bobby, I don't eat that. That's garbage, right? I go for something premium like brownberry whole grain oat nut. Whole grain is good, but you have to read the ingredients because it can be mixed in with other stuff. Case in point. Okay, first ingredient here for this one, whole wheat flour. That's good. It's a good place to start because it has all the nutrition still on the grain. But the third ingredient then is unbleached enriched wheat flour. So they're throwing the cruddy flour in there with the better one. Then you keep going, it's like, hey, we stripped it out there, so we gotta put back the synthetic vitamins. We see more of that soybean oil, highly inflammatory, highly processed. And after that, it's not too bad. Actually, you know what? It is bad because see oats right there? See oats all over the bread? My friends, if oats are not organic, they score high in glyphosate. What's glyphosate? Glyphosate is the active ingredient in Monsanto's Roundup. Why do they spray it on oats? I thought GMO crops were like soy and corn. They are. But things have gotten so crazy, they spray it on wheat and they spray it on oats at the end of the harvesting process as a desiccant to dry it out so it's easier to harvest it. So unless it's organic oats, it's really bad news because it scores high in that. Same is true for wheat. So unless your bread is organic wheat, it's gonna score high in glyphosate. So that's really bad news. So then we start going to better news, okay? Here we go. You see organic on Dave's Killer Bread. Best logo ever. This guy looks like a angelic, dreamy guitar player, right? Organic means they can't spray it with glyphosate. That's great. Now, I love the weight of this bread too. It's very, very heavy, meaning it's using a lot of whole grains and seeds. And back in the day, I did give this my blessing as a Bobby approved bread, but things have changed. Why have they changed? Well, let's focus on the good. It starts with organic whole wheat flour. Great. Then we go down here. Look at this, you guys. It's literally a blend of, what is it? 21 whole grains, nuts, and seeds. I see kamut, spelt, sesame seeds, all these things are great. They have canola oil there. It is expeller pressed, organic. Not ideal, but much better than non-organic canola oil. My problem is up high is cane sugar. How much cane sugar? I've never seen a bread, a savory bread that had 5 grams of added sugar per slice. Wow. My friends, 5 grams of added sugar is over 1 teaspoon of added sugar per slice. That's really bad news, because once you start adding that to probably jams and jelly, which I'll talk about in a second too, you're talking about a lot of sugar. You're combining, mixing sugar with starch and sugar and fat, a toxic combination for getting fat and sick and diabetes. So that's off my list, unfortunately. A better one would be angelic. And the better one actually is in the freezer case. Angelic is nice because it's sprouted bread. If you're gonna eat bread, I highly recommend eating sprouted bread, because sprouted grains like whole grains, wheat, berries, quinoa, sprouted grains are easier on your tummy to digest, and your body derives more nutrition from them. That being said, this one also adds a little bit of natural flavor and what else here? Agave syrup. How much? It's 1 gram. I still don't wanna see added sugar to my bread, but natural flavor is another word for artificial flavors, and I don't see the word organic anywhere, do you? So that's a no to me. So really quickly, let's go walk over and show the best in class bread here at Costco. Then we'll come back and talk about the best nut butters and jams to spread on your bread. Oh, actually, you know what? We can't go over it yet, because here, it's right here. I know you guys were gonna ask this question. Keto bread. There's 2 keto breads I've heard about at Costco. There's the Natural Ovens one, and there's the Sola. Unfortunately, this is nowhere near Bobby approved, because even though the net carbs are 0 per slice, well, how do they go about doing that? Don't just look at the net carbs. Look at what they put in here. Look at this. It's modified wheat starch. It's wheat gluten. Then they put a ton of fiber in there to back out the carbs, but they're using soybean oil, the worst possible oil ever. And the wheat they're using is not organic, so it's high in glyphosate. So I have a problem, because I think the keto diet is being ruined by people trying to jump on the bandwagon and say, hey, well, this is low carb, this is a fat bomb. And when you're using inferior ingredients like soybean oil, canola oil, fake sugars, and stuff like that, that's the wrong way to do keto. And yes, this is zero net carb bread. I would much rather you go online. There is a company called Base Culture. They make a much cleaner bread. It's a little more expensive, but even the Sola brand, read the ingredients. They use processed, I believe it's soybean or canola oil on that one too, or maybe it's sunflower oil, but it's not clean. Clean keto is the way to go. Okay, there's my rant. A lot of rants today, huh? Let's go over to the freezer case and show you that best-in-class bread. There she blows, folks. There it is, the best-in-class Bobby-approved bread, not just here at Costco, but pretty much anywhere. It's Ezekiel 4-9 bread. This brand, Food for Life, they're OGs. They do it right. Why? Because number one, it's sprouted. It's organic. But look at these ingredients here, you guys. There's no added sugar. There's no added filler. It's all organic, sprouted, yummy goodness. Added sugar, 0. Is it low carb or paleo? No. But does it matter? No, because if you're gonna eat bread, make it count. What do I mean by making it count? Make sure it's sprouted grains. Make sure it's gonna satiate your hunger because of that. Make sure it's organic because of the glyphosate level. And make sure it's darn tasty. Now, I know some kids don't love the hardiness of this bread. There's other brands. So there's a brand called Silver Hills. They make a blue bag called Little Big Bread. And it's sprouted and it's a little more fluffy like a sandwich bread. I made my ultimate grilled cheese with that and it's fantastic. The price here is amazing. The only negative is the loaves are huge. They're so big that they kind of dwarf the size of any sandwich or any fixings you can put on there. That might be the only negative. Otherwise, this is the way to go. If you eat grains, make them count. Make them like this. Back in the bread and jams and jellies aisle. This is probably the best nut butter on the market and at Costco. Nutso. It is insane. Power fuel is the exact word it is, because look at the ingredients here. I've never seen a combination of these kind of ingredients here. Amazing fat, amazing protein, amazing iron from the chia seeds. And look at the salt. Celtic sea salt is what I use at home to cook with. Celtic sea salt is unrefined, unprocessed, and that price. I know it seems expensive, but it literally is half the price of the grocery store. This is absolutely fantastic. It's just ironic that it's sitting right next to one of the most toxic nut butters in the world, Nutella. And people love this stuff, but you guys, it is scary, scary bad for you. There is a better one on Amazon I'll tell you about in a second. But you know you have a problem when the first ingredient is sugar. But how much sugar? Well, there's 19 grams of added sugar, 19 in a 2 tablespoon serving. Y'all, 19 grams of sugar is just about 5 teaspoons. Can you imagine 5 teaspoons of sugar going in little Timmy, little Jill's mouth, every 2 tablespoons she's eating or he's eating? That is wrong. Also wrong is followed by palm oil. Palm oil is devastating for the environment. It's also devastating for our bodies, just as processed as canola and soybean, and just as bad for our bodies. And then just to top it off, a little bit of artificial flavors to really make the kids addicted to those flavors. When you combine fat and sugar like that, that is, in my opinion, a deadly combination for getting fat and type 2 diabetes. I am not joking, my friends. These are the kind of products that are really, really bad. And then when you put it on some really cruddy bread, you're combining carbs, fat, and sugar. Bad news. One of my favorite peanut butters on the market is the Costco. It's organic, which is great because peanut butters are legumes. And when you're buying nut butter, we have a whole video about this if you want to watch afterwards. It should only have one or two ingredients. This one just has nuts and salt. It's not Celtic sea salt, but there's no palm oil, no sugar in there. They have the best deal also on almond butter. You don't have to buy almond butter organic, and this is great. How good is the price? I mean, that's literally half the price of grocery stores, and two 28 ounce containers of peanut butter for $10, that's winning. We also have a video we did recently all about jams and jellies, which can be sugar bombs. And if they're not organic berries, you have a problem because all berries score high in glyphosates and a lot of nasties you don't want to put in your body. So after that video, a lot of folks said, hey, Bobby, how about the organic strawberry spread? Because strawberries are always on the dirty dozen. And it's great, grand, wonderful that it's organic, but 8 grams of added sugar per tablespoon? Guys, that's 2 teaspoons. 2 teaspoons of sugar for every 1 tablespoon. Yeah, the price is right here. But that's way too much. Go check out that video. I have a couple really good Bobby approved low sugar jellies, and there's a clean version. It's actually keto too, of the Nutella using erythritol and hazelnuts and organic cacao on Amazon. It's fantastic. It tastes almost just as good as the real thing, and it's not nearly as toxic. It's actually pretty good except for one or two ingredients, but wow, that's it. So, oh, here's one more brand new one. keep going. I saw this the other day. I almost jumped out of my pants, but something bad happened. Yum superfood butters. I love when butters are made with amazing ingredients like cashews, chia seeds, hemp seeds, and gojis, because chia seeds are high in protein, iron, omega-3s. Hemp seeds are fantastic in omega-3s and protein and iron, all that good stuff. But this is one of my pet peeves in life, you guys. When these companies are charging you premium prices and using premium ingredients except for one, I get really mad. So what's the oil you see there? They're using palm oil and sunflower oil. What's the oil you see in the top one? Palm oil. These oils are bad for you. I don't care if it's organic. They're still highly processed. They're bad. If you're gonna put any oil, you gotta put coconut oil or avocado oil in there. Sunflower oil, even if it was organic expeller pressed, which is less processed, is not nearly as good. I have a pet peeve. This is me on my pedestal here. When you're gonna make a premium product, that's either paleo, keto, or just really top notch, and charge me a premium price like these guys are, you cannot use bad quality oils. That doesn't fly. Be a leader by example. Use coconut oil, extra virgin, avocado, not these cruddy plant-based processed oils. That's it. Okay. Wow, what a great rant there. That's it, you guys. The best bread to buy at Costco by far is the Ezekiel frozen sprouted organic bread. Now you know what to look for when you see these loaves of bread. Don't be confused by what you see on the product package. Read the ingredients. If you have any other requests or want to see more reviews here at Costco, I was thinking about doing a booze review of Costco. Let me know. But like, subscribe, share. The only way this channel keeps growing is by you spreading that big old love. I got 2 more Costco videos going below me right now. I will see you soon. Hashtag keep on cooking. Mad love. These are driving me crazy. Peace. Later, y'all.